First, I'm gonna disconnect the battery. We do this to prevent any shortages to the LCD or the motherboard. So to do that, you wanna flip the unit over and take out all of the bottom cover screws. Now you can take your sparger and take the bottom cover off. And then disconnect the battery cable from the motherboard. Now that the battery is unplugged, you can take out all of the screws and the palm rest. Now that all the screws are out, you can open the unit up just a little bit to open the hinges. And start removing the internal parts. So you can remove the battery. And remove the speakers and disconnect them from the motherboard. Then you can disconnect the two USB ribbons. And carefully remove the USB board. And then you can disconnect the Wi-Fi cables and the LCD cable and the camera cable, the touchpad ribbon and the keyboard ribbon. And then while handling the motherboard, you just want to make sure that you are grounded to prevent any static electricity damage to the board. And now you can carefully remove the motherboard. And now you can open the unit up to remove the palm rest. Now you can grab your new palm rest. Start by flipping it over and lining the hinges up. Once they're lined up, you can grab both the palm rest and the hinges and lay the unit down. And then just open the unit up a little bit to get those hinges to open up. Take your motherboard and carefully put it back into place. And then you can set this hinge down. Take the USB board and carefully put that back into place. That hinge down and reconnect the two USB ribbons. now reconnect the speakers and put those back into place and wrap the wire back around these clips. Put the battery back into place, but do not reconnect the battery yet. And now you can reconnect all of the remaining cables and wires except for the battery. Whenever you reconnect the two Wi-Fi connectors, just make sure that the white wire goes by the white arrow and the black wire goes by the black arrow. Connect the camera cable. And the LCD cable. Touchpad ribbon. And the keyboard ribbon. And now that everything is reconnected, we can put all of the screws back in. We can reconnect the battery to the motherboard. And then put the bottom cover back on. And put the bottom cover screws back in. Thank you. like to verify the repair, you can take your AC adapter and plug the unit in, and then open the unit up. And if the unit turns on, that means the replacement was successful. And if you would like to see if the battery is working properly, you can unplug the AC. And if the unit stays on with it unplugged, that means the battery is working. So now you can shut the unit off.